Hey everyone, welcome back to the channel. Today I have something different. I recently received this laptop from a friend of mine for free. As you can see, the body of this laptop is in pretty good condition, but the screen is slightly damaged. Considering the price of this laptop, which is zero, I shouldn't complain at all. On the right hand side, we got a DVD drive and two USB 3.0 ports. At the back, we have an Ethernet port for internet connections, and an HDMI port for external monitors. On the left hand side, we got a VGA connector and two more USB ports. Over here in the front, we have a Wi-Fi on-off switch and a SD card reader. Overall, I would say this laptop is quite suitable as a multimedia hub, just like a PlayStation 3. Let's also have a look at the bottom. This laptop is made in Japan, which is not common to see these days. It also reminds me of the good old days of removable battery, which is very nostalgic to me. On the battery, it also says made in Korea. I guess there were more items made outside China back in the day. Alright, enough physical inspection. Let's do some software benchmarking to see how good this laptop is. The first software we're going to benchmark with is Blender. Let's test the i5 CPU first. When running the test, the CPU is using a maximum of 1 volt and the temperature is around 60 degrees Celsius. It takes a few minutes to finish the whole benchmark. Once it finished, it returns a score, 11.34. I guess it is a very low number. As we can see, other laptops can go as high as 5000. Anyhow, we are in the top 100%. Next, let's try running the same test with the GPU. For some reasons, I keep getting this error no matter how many times I try. After some diggings, it seems this GPU is just too old to run the test. I have no choice but to move on to the next benchmark, Cinebench. But again, this laptop is just too old. Well, then let's try 3D Mark. Oh my god. What a great performance. I watched the whole thing and have no idea what's going on with that 1 frame per second. But anyhow, we got a score, 166. The GPU score is 145 and the CPU score is 1162. Here's the specifications of the laptop, the FPS during the test, and the CPU and GPU temperatures and usage. Let's also test a game. We have less than 10 FPS, it's super laggy, totally unplayable. When seeing such a horrendous performance, a normal person will simply toss aside this ancient relic. But this is amateur hardware repair here, so let's break this laptop open. We have tons of unscrewing to do at the very beginning. Remember to check the screw type from time to time to make sure they have the same size and same length. When you encounter a different screw type, remember the location where it comes from, so that later you can put everything back together correctly. Usually, we need to remove the hard drive before we can remove the bottom case. Now, the front side is loose, but strangely, the back side just won't open. After some inspections, it seems the back side of the case is glued together. After careful consideration, I decided to cut open the case using a plastic pick. I hope I'm not going to break anything. We can finally open the case, and indeed, it is glued together. Look at all these glue marks. I have no idea why they need to glue it. If you know, leave a comment. Now, we can remove the heatsink and expose the CPU. After more than 10 years, the thermal pastes are all dry. Since we are already here, let's change the CMOS battery to keep the clock running. Next, we need to clean up all the dry thermal paste on both the CPU and GPU. The CPU is now as pristine as a mirror. It's time to upgrade the CPU from i5 to i7. Unlike most modern laptops where CPUs are soldered on the motherboard, we have a G2 socket here. This means I can easily swap out the CPU for a more powerful one. I really wish we could swap out the RSX processor on the PS3 as easily as this. It's time to plug in the new CPU. Remember to double check the orientation by looking at the arrow sign here. Once the orientation is confirmed, carefully insert it into the socket. Make sure the CPU is properly seated, then tighten it securely with a screwdriver. Before we assemble everything back together, let's take a moment to clean the fan. The power cable of the fan can be challenging to unplug. Pulling it straight up could damage both the connector and the motherboard. Instead, gently wiggle the connector left and right until it loosens. Oh no, it's so dirty. There's a decade's worth of dust inside. After cleaning the fan, reassembling the laptop is quite straightforward. Finally, let's power it on and check the new CPU. Oh no, did I break anything? Oh wait, I forgot to put the hard disk back. Now let's try again. Yes, it works. But I found another problem. For some reasons, I can't get anything displayed on the external monitor, even though the laptop can recognize the monitor is being connected. So I tear it apart again and have a look at the HDMI port. Can you see it? I can see something wrong already. Let's plug a HDMI cable to it and see what happens. I guess this is the reason. I can see some pins are missing from the connector. But the question is, did I break it during the teardown? Here's a photo I took before I do anything to it. Oh, it was like this at the very beginning. Well, I guess I have to benchmark the new CPU without the external monitor. The final score is just slightly higher than the i5 CPU. Let's try 3D Mark again. The benchmark is still super laggy, but after upgrading, we get more than double the score. We also get double the FPS with the new CPU. It's quite interesting to see upgrading the CPU also improves the GPU performance. Here are a few more graphs for the benchmark. Finally, let's test the same game again. The gameplay is surprisingly smooth after the upgrade. When I say smooth, I mean it's still a bit laggy, but now it's at least playable compared to the old CPU. I guess that's it for today. Thank you for watching till the end. Let me know in the comment section below if you think I wasted my time and money upgrading this piece of junk. Oh, we still need to fix the HDMI port on this laptop, but I suppose that will be the focus of my next video. Now, how difficult is the upgrade in terms of PS3 difficulty? I would personally give it 1 out of 5 PS3 score, but the bottom case is slightly difficult to remove, so I would give it 1.5 out of 5 PS3 score. Alright, have fun repairing, see you next time.